is set for one ball. Introducing first, from the Queen's Court, Lord Littlebrook presents one half of the royal family, Jacko.
Jacko Victory, led to the ring by Lord Littlebrook. This should be an outstanding contest to kick it off here. Boy, we have got it packed tonight. 90 minutes, and it's great. Let's go back to Jerry Capetta.
And his opponent, from Lexington, Tennessee, weighing 224 pounds, Hotstuff, Eddie Gilbert.
Fans, while Hotstuff makes his way to the ring, remember, a great card tonight in Daytona. At the Ocean Center. Of course, tomorrow night we'll be in Miami Beach. Looking forward to that. 7 o'clock starting time tomorrow night at the FIU Arena. That's Florida International University Arena. 7 o'clock starting time. Over 30 of the greatest stars in the NWA will be in Miami tomorrow night. This Monday night in Fort Pierce, the St. Lucie Civic Center. And then moving north on Tuesday to Saginaw, Wednesday to Dayton. NWA Thursday night will be in Toledo, Ohio, at a benefit in Farmland, Indiana. And of course, the big one this Friday night in Chicago, and 1 week from tonight in St. Louis. More on the travels of the NWA as this program progresses.
Did I hear you say a benefit?
That's right.
A benefit where?
Farmland, Indiana, this Thursday night.
That's not one of those benefits that allows these redneck farmers to grow more corn or something, is it?
It might be.
Well, I'm not going to let the Midnight Express be a part of that thing, because I don't like farmers, especially in Indiana.
Well, you know, you sure have been eating some of their grub. So think about that the next time you chew.
I don't eat grub, and if you don't watch out, we'll be chewing you up, Jim Ross. I'm not going to take any more of this stuff around here. Straightening things out.
Jacko Victory, straight right hand to Hotstuff Eddie Gilbert. Stealing the U.S. tag titles.
We didn't steal them. Pillman and Zink stole them. That's, I'm going to have more to talk about later on about that.
Good.
But they are in the rightful owner's possession now.
Jacko Victory, an outstanding competitor, one half of the royal family. We'll see his counterpart, Rip Morgan, against Tommy Wildfire Rich a little bit later in the program. Hotstuff Eddie Gilbert, great offensive move there. As we look over the shoulder of Lord Littlebrook.
Which ain't an easy thing to do unless you can bend severely at the waist. Eddie Gilbert, just like all the Gilberts, I know the whole family, the whole stinking clan, he always attacks from behind.
Yeah, you know, you could bend over the waist to see anybody.
Hey, let me tell you something. All I know is I'm a happy man these days. We got the U.S. tag team belts. We fixed up Flying Brian. And now I'm watching. Oh! I'm watching Jacko Victory. He's going to beat Eddie Hotstuff Gilbert right here in the middle of the ring.
Gilbert with the arm bar on Jacko Victory. Great program today, the ghetto street fight. And that's what the no disqualification match. Oh, Gilbert tripped over Victory.
Victory threw his body down right in the middle of Gilbert's path. Holy mackerel. He threw him down right in the middle of Gilbert's path, tripped him through the ropes, and then knocked him off the apron, and his leg went into that steel barricade, trapped itself in between those spokes.
Littlebrook put a size 3 or whatever it is on Hotstuff Eddie Gilbert. I don't think that's going to hurt him, but his knee is certainly taking the blunt of the blow here as Jacko Victory comes to the outside, kicking on that leg, trying to further injure it.
That's what I like. Jacko Victory is a man who knows how to pick out his body parts well.
Fans, promoter Gary Jester wanted me to remind you, a great card 1 week from tomorrow in Baltimore at the arena. It's been a long time since the NWA has been in one of the red hot cities in our great land. That's Baltimore. And Gilbert's leg wrapped right around that steel ring post. Gilbert, who is a very quick individual. Victory is full aware of that. He's very familiar with Hotstuff Eddie Gilbert. He knows to lessen the mobility will increase his chances for victory.
Gilbert uses his speed more than almost any other wrestler in the NWA. He's got to, because he lacks the weight. So he uses the speed, and he outsmarts his opponent usually. But in this case, Jacko Victory's got the right answer. Take those legs out from under him. I want to know, how did you manage to get your last name on all of our ring posts here in the NWA, Jim?
Excuse me? That says Rose, R-O-O-S. That's the greatest shoe made today. It's the official shoe of the NWA and World Championship Wrestling. I'll have you know.
I thought it said Ross.
No.
He's one of the greatest heels in the world today.
Well, that's only your opinion.
And well, people have told me you got a lot of soul.
Well, you're really cute these days, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm cuter than you've ever seen.
Steel championship belts.
Oh, don't start.
Cost you $1,000 a day, I hear.
$1,000 a day. I'll cover that later on, too. I got some things to say about everything going on in the NWA. Just stay tuned to the program.
That's a surprise. Jacko Victory still working on that leg of hot stuff Eddie Gilbert, who cannot stand at this juncture. Boy, this is a great program, and I mean it is packed. We have got so much action, including that big tag team event, Kevin Sullivan and Cactus Jack against Mike Rotunda, the captain, and Big Norman.
Big Norman, yeah, big, stupid, ugly Norman. He's so ugly in the morning, he has to ambush breakfast. Are you kidding? That's good. I'm going to love to see Kevin Sullivan in a slaughterhouse take care of Mike Rotunda and Norman right here on today's main event.
Victory again. Working on the leg of hot stuff Eddie Gilbert, and obviously Gilbert is in a great deal of pain. What's Little Brook going to do? Take a shortcut?
No, Little Brook, he was just testing his reflexes. He was afraid that the man's leg was injured, so he gave him that reflex test like the doctor does, you know?
Right. Boy, you have a vivid imagination, do you not?
Everything about me is vivid. Yeah, Jacko Victory working on the man.
He's taking his boot off and nailing Gilbert right in the knee with it. Referee is, this is a marginal call here, as I'm sure Nick Patrick, who was chastising Jacko Victory. It's not a disqualification to take a man's boot off, but to use it on him is.
Well, it's not a foreign object because wrestler's equipment is allowed in the ring. So that right there would have to go before the courts. Right now, I'd say Gilbert ought to wear lace-up boots.
Gilbert trying to fight back as he reels back to the corner, and Jacko Victory went to the corner. Nobody was there. Gilbert sent him for the ride, trying to get him up for the hot shot, but his leg buckled. Eddie Gilbert has little, if any, mobility left in this contest.
Oh, yeah, and Victory's slapping him. He's slapping him. Get up. That's what he's saying to Gilbert. Yeah, like I said, I know the whole family. They're from Tennessee.
I'm going to be talking to the number one contender and a man I consider to be the next world's heavyweight champion, Lex Luger, live right here on World Championship Wrestling before we go off the air. So stay tuned for that.
When are you going to get off this thing? Lex Luger will never be world champion because Ric Flair is. The Horsemen have been running roughshod over all the competition. Oh, Gilbert from behind. Take move by Hot Stuff. Did he hold him down? Yes, he did.
Here's your winner, Hot Stuff,
quick. In his quickness, he had some left. A hard-fought victory for Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
You can see on the replay, he slipped down behind Jacko Victory, pulled him over, and in a big handful of tights. Right there, his left hand was all in the man's tights. Led Eddie Gilbert in a victory.
We're going to rock and roll right after this time.
Oh, no.